focus on attracts money for me. Money comes to me in ways I expect and ways I don't expect. My money grows beyond what I could have ever dreamed of. I attract money and wealth into my life. Everybody can be rich, even me. I choose money and wealth every day. Money creates a positive impact in my life. I deserve to be abundant. Money is easy for me to attract. I deserve to prosper. Everything I desire is making its way to me. My money is unlimited. My bank account is always full of money. I now have massive amounts of money. My investments are successful and return me money. The more fun I have, the more money I make. The happier I am, the more money I attract. I let go of all my fears about money. I have a lot of money coming to me right now. My income is always going up. If other people can be rich and wealthy, so can I. Prosperity is alive in each area of my life. My money grows beyond my wildest dreams. I have enough money to help the people in my life. I have unlimited abundance. I consciously create my own reality and I enjoy living in it. I design the life I desire. I think big. My consistent focus is on abundance and it is attracted to me. I do great things with my money. I only focus on what I want to see. All the resources I need to attract money are inside of me. I am always open to ways to attract more money. I always find new ways to attract money. I love abundance and I attract it easily. My income is going up. I am happy, healthy, and rich. Prosperity is inside of me and all around me. Money is a source of energy, so it is good to have money. I have a lot of money and that I deserve it. My life is filled with more than money. My prosperity is unlimited. I think positive thoughts about money. My mind attracts money. I have the right to be prosperous. I expect and welcome good fortune in every part of my life. I think positively about love, life, peace, great health, wealth, and abundance. Abundance is inside of me and around me. Everything is going well for me every day. I like money, and money likes me too. Money comes easily, often, and abundantly. I have an excellent financial future. I am now free to do the things I love. I choose wealth. I am a money magnet. Money is constantly attracted to me. My prosperous thoughts create my prosperous world. I enjoy my prosperity and share it freely with others. I am a loving and abundant person. I see opportunities all around me. I allow myself to have the good things in life, and I enjoy them. Opportunities flow to me with ease. I can buy anything I want. Feeling joyful attracts abundance. Abundance flows easily to me. My income is more than my expenses. My income keeps rising all the time. I have a great life. I don't have to work for money. I deserve an abundant life. My thoughts and actions bring me a steady flow of money. I'm open to new ways to attract money. I attract money while I sleep. I am attracted to money. I'm attracted to wealth and good fortune. I attract money to myself. I always have more than enough. I am in sync with the energy of wealth. There is always money around me. I release anything that keeps me from attracting wealth and abundance. New opportunities for money flow to me. I use money to improve my own life and the lives of other people. Money has a positive effect on my life. Money is unlimited. Money serves me well. I am meeting the right people to help me reach my goals. Money comes to me freely. I deserve more money. I deserve to have all the wealth I want. I love my life and everything it gives me. I am successful. It is up to me to achieve the success and wealth that I want in my life. I have a lot of money. I move from poverty thinking to a
morning and welcome to The Money Matrix. I am Dion Pouncil.
And I'm Dominique Broadway. Welcome to another very exciting solar eclipse day and week in the markets. Please also do not forget that investing and trading should happen at your own risk. So please do your own research before making any trading or investing decisions.
Yes, yes. And if I'm speaking low, just bear with me today. I have a sore throat and just wanted to make it to the show and push through, okay? Yes. So Tesla shares popped. Tesla shares pop on Musk announcement that robo-taxis will be unveiled on August 8th, okay? So Musk has been in the news reportedly multiple times over the last couple of weeks as Tesla shares had slumped. They slumped in Q1, and they had slumping since the announcement that they had the potential to miss some deliveries or shorted numbers than expected on deliveries. And so now a lot of people believe that this announcement for the auto taxis is him trying to put the cape on and save Tesla's stock. And, you know, the Tesla believers believe that they're actually going to be delivered on this coming August. So robo-taxis, fully autonomous vehicles where you can order just like an Uber app and it will come pick you up and take you to where you're going to be. So we are literally living in the future.
That's very exciting, but taxi drivers are going to tear these cars up, okay? Like, taxi drivers are already mad at the Uber drivers, but when this time comes that they're like, people are literally, it's going to be,
well, if that's the case, then it shouldn't be just Uber driver. I mean, taxis, it should be Uber drivers too, right?
True. Mm-hmm. Very true. But I think taxis, they've already, there. I feel like this is like the thing that's going to take them over the edge. Like, this is the thing that's going to make them see red, you know? But yeah, Uber drivers too. Yeah, this is a, humans need not apply. Mm-hmm. All right. Today, as we guys know, is the solar eclipse day, okay? The solar eclipse day, which I am very, very excited about. Everyone's very, very excited about, but it's like I also don't have those special glasses, so I probably won't see the eclipse, but I'll see pictures of it after. So it's kind of like everyone's excited to see something they're not going to see unless you got those glasses. But one of the, there's actually a lot of companies that are going to be able to profit off of the solar eclipse, believe it or not. So companies such as Delta, Krispy Kreme, and Pizza Hut are all releasing products and showcasing basic. They're expecting to make $1.5 billion just off this hype around the solar eclipse. I know we were in the grocery store the other day, and they were like, you know, get these items for your solar eclipse party. They had cookies and cakes and all these different things. So very exciting to see how that affects some of these stocks, especially even Delta. They are releasing their earnings this Friday, and I also heard that Americans have spent like over $4 million, I can't remember which one, just to make sure that they're in the flight or travel related to see the solar eclipse. So people are excited about it.
Oh, wow. Yeah. I mean, well, it's the first time in 99 years. So it is.
No, it was like 1979 or something. Somebody had found the article and it was like, you know, we're saying this today. We won't see it again for 2024 because, of course, that seemed so long ago. Mm-hmm. But yeah, that was really cool. Somebody found the newspaper.
Yeah. So, you know, it's a once or twice in a lifetime situation. And, you know, it is something that's limited. So we'll see if it lives up to the hype. Okay. So in the AI wars, TSM has received some chip funding. TSMC's Arizona subsidiary will receive up to $6.6 billion in government funding under a preliminary agreement announced by the Biden administration on Monday. If you all remember, TSM is the sleeper stock I gave everybody at the top of the year when it was only around $80. So hopefully you all are riding that ride up. The financing of the Taiwanese multinational semiconductor company is under the CHIPS and Science Act, a $53 billion package passed in 2022 to build the domestic chip industry. The funds announced Monday will support TSMC's more than $65 billion investment in three fabrication plants in Phoenix. The package will include $50 million to train and develop talent in Arizona, adding to the more than 25,000 jobs that TSMC has created in the state. So shout out to TSMC, the government, for making the funding, Phoenix for getting that company and a lot of the people that are, you know, new job creations. It's always exciting.
Very, very. All right, next up in for further airline news is Spirit Airlines. So apparently they're going to be deferring some of their big Airbus orders because they will actually be furloughing 260 pilots, which is interesting because I think there's been like a pilot shortage lately. So I guess a lot of these Spirit Airline pilots will be available to go to a lot of other airlines. And apparently there's this, what's it called, pilot shortage, because it takes a long time for someone to become a pilot. Like, it's not like something you could wake up today and be like, I want to be a pilot, apply for the job, and go next week. It doesn't go down like that. Mm-hmm. It takes people years, right? And so there is a shortage of people applying for these jobs. So I guess the good thing is these other, you know, Spirit Airline pilots will probably be able to get jobs pretty quickly at some of these other airlines that have been searching high and low for pilots.
Mm. Okay. Literally flying hot. Mm. Okay. In other news, Paramount, we're talking deal or no deal, okay? Skydance Media, Redbird Capital, and KKR have entered exclusive talks for a stake in Paramount Global. The consortium wants to acquire a stake in the deal that will keep Paramount publicly traded. Skydance CEO David Ellison and Redbird's Jeff Shell, the former CEO of NBC Universal, would have leadership roles if the deal is approved. The proposed deal would not be complete takeover of the Paramount that the company's board prefers. So Paramount has been in the streaming wars for a while now, and now this new group is talking about taking a major stake. So we shall see how that affects Paramount's stock if the takeover actually happens, and what will happen to one of the major streaming giants. Okay. All right, now let's transition into our beat.
I have one more piece of news.
Sorry about that. Sorry.
All right, my last piece of news. We have another IPO on the deck. As you guys know, one of our most exciting IPOs that we've had so far this year has been Reddit. We have another pretty exciting company. So Walmart, Ibotta, actually, which is backed by Walmart, has announced that they will be doing their IPO, and I believe... they are going to, I think it'll be around $2.6 billion or so that they're actually going to receive from this IPO. Not sure if the IPO date has been set yet, but pretty exciting to see that this company, Ibotta, which I know I've used, like coupons, whatever, is actually going to be going public very soon. So we'll keep you posted when we find out the actual IPO date.
Okay. And now, transitioning into our Beat the Bell segment.
Here comes the money.
We're going to cover some pre-market news, global market analysis, and hop into some charts and see if we have some opportunities for some live day and or swing trades today. All right. Now, kicking it off in the Asian market, the Asian Dow was up 0.37%. The Nikkei 225 up 0.91%. The Hang Seng Index up 0.05%. The Shanghai Index down 0.72%, the Sensex Index up 0.67%, and Singapore down 0.07%.
Love it. Not for Singapore. All the other Asia. All right, so U.S. this morning, let's look at our U.S. equities. So we have the Dow is currently up 0.80%, the S&P 500 is up 1.11%, the NASDAQ is up 1.24%, that VIX is down 1.12%. Gold is also up 0.08%, and then oil is down 0.45%.
All right, hopping right over to the futures market, the Dow Jones futures is up 0.14%. S&P 500 futures are up 0.21%. The NASDAQ futures are up 0.31%. Gold is up 0.08%. Silver is up 1.1%, and crude oil down 0.33%. Hopping right over into the Forex market, the euro is relatively flat, up 0.01%. The Japanese yen is up 0.15%. The Great British pound is relatively flat, down 0.02%. The Australian dollar is up 0.32%. The DXY index is down 0.01%. And the Wall Street Journal dollar index is down 0.01%.
All right, crypto, let me tell y'all, it's up across the board. I've been getting notifications all night long about crypto hitting, going and rising back up. All it does is this whole thing. Bitcoin is currently up 4.20%. Their halving event is supposed to be taking place in, I guess, just 12 days, April the 20th. They're currently trading very, very close to 72,000. Ethereum is currently up 7.51%, trading around 3,656. XRP is up 2.52%. Bitcoin Cash is up 1.83%. Litecoin is up 2.81%. And then Monero is up 0.71%.
Okay. Now we'll hop over into our charts, do some pre-market analysis, see if we have some opportunities for some day trades, okay? Looking at our swing trade positions, currently down pre-market around 36K. We only took off three active trades last week for about $17,000 in profit. So this is our second week of trading for April, and then we'll see how we'll fare. Okay. As far as our stock screener algo, we'll refresh. We'll see some top stocks in play will be Tesla, Micron Technology, Coinbase, and Hood. So we'll come back and take a look at those shortly. Kicking it off in the futures market, we'll start off in the NASDAQ. On the 1 week chart, we can see that it's been trading up since November 6th of 23. On the 1 day chart, it is at a sell signal, starting to get some support around that first standard deviation. On the 2 hour, it did get a buy signal at 6 a.m. this morning and has pretty much been charging up since Friday around 8 a.m. On the 1 hour, we are in a buy signal since 6 a.m. this morning. So we could look to be buy side bias on the equities at the open and let the data lead throughout the rest of the day. It might be a potential sell-off in the afternoon, okay, or towards the later half of the show. Checking out into the bonds. On the 10 years, interest rates have been in the sell since Monday, March 18th on the 1 week chart. On the 1 day chart, been selling off since April 1st. On the 2 hour, been in a sell-off since Friday at 4 a.m. And in the 1 hour, has been trending down since April 5th, Friday at 1 a.m. So sell side bias on the interest rates. And if there continue to be sell side bias throughout the day, that will give us some more green hopes for the equities. But buy side bias on the equities at the open, sell side bias on the bonds. Hopping over into the metals, gold has been charging up. Some new highs. It's been charging up since February 26th on the 1 week chart. On the 1 day chart, started the trend February 20th, and the latest was March 26th on the 1 day chart. The 2 hour is in a buy signal since Friday, April 5th at 4 a.m. And the 1 hour is in a sell this morning at 8. So gold may open for a temporary sell off and then look to be up for the rest of the day. Rounded it out in the energies market. Crude oil on the 1 week, crude oil has reached all-time highs, trading at almost around $100 a barrel. It's been in a buy signal since January 22nd. On the 1 week chart, it's been in a buy since March 28th on the 1 day. The 2 hour has been in a buy since 6 a.m. this morning, and the 1 hour in a buy since 3 this morning. So we're going to be buy side bias on the equities and the energy markets, sell side bias at the open on interest rates and the metals. Dominique?
Yeah. How you feeling? You okay?
Back.
Yeah, we got to actually, we got to, I may have to run grab you some tea real quick. You got to keep that throat.
Man.
What's your rise? All right. So this morning, as Dion mentioned, looks like equities have a lot of upside potential as we head into the market. I'm currently in a U.S. 100 trade on U.S. Tech 100 trade on NASDAQ that I've been in since last night, which is finally, on the NADEX, which is finally turning profitable this morning and looking for that initial upside at the opening bell. Looking at a couple options that we're eyeing today. One, definitely NVIDIA, just because, hey, it always makes us money. We are currently the 1 minute. So currently NVIDIA is up $6.92. We have a buy put. It's actually been in a buy call all this morning. Now we're in a buy put for the last like 4 or 5 minutes. This will likely bounce off of this first standard deviation. My bars are gone. Yeah, and then bounce up is likely what will happen here, I'm anticipating, but we'll see as we're getting closer to the market open. We're about a minute away. So it looks like this will likely be up today, but we'll see how that goes. So that's currently on the 1 minute chart. And then also on that 5 minute, we're still in that buy put. All right. So looks like there's still some upside potential there. Another one that we're eyeing this morning is Delta Airlines. All right. So Delta Airlines currently on the 5 minute chart, we're in that buy call. In the 1 minute chart, we are also still in this buy call. This bar is looking like it's trying to turn around. But we'll see how that goes. The market open. They're currently up 24 cents. All right, 24 cents as we head into the open. All right, we'll take a quick look at the SPY as well as we get closer to this open to see. It's currently up 68 cents. We're still in this buy put, but we are about to open and we'll see if these things turn around. And as you can see, it's already chasing and trying to turn around with this bar, as the market has officially opened. All right, so tons of upside potential. We have NVIDIA that is currently up. This has to refresh. Still says, let this refresh. Still says pre-market. All right, it looks like, I'm gonna make sure. Accurate. All right, so I think this is accurate. I hope so. SMCI Super Micro Computer is currently in this buy put. NVIDIA, okay, looks like it's refreshed down. We're still in this buy put as well, currently up about $5.20. But we're only a minute in, and some of these things may likely start to turn around just a tad. So as you can see, a lot of these stocks are kind of flat, not as much movement as I was expecting to see this morning at the opening bell, but it looks like some of the volume is actually starting to pick up a little bit here. So NVIDIA is starting to rise. Let's see if we still have, we're still in this put on the 1 minute chart for NVIDIA and on the 5 minute chart, okay? Another one I wanna take a quick look at is Palantir. We're also in a buy put for that on the 5 minute as well. So I guess we'll kind of take a look to see how some of these stocks will pan out, all right? So please make sure you drop into the chat anything that you would like for us to take a look at, any stocks, futures, Forex, crypto, am I missing anything? Anything like that, go ahead and drop those into the chat. I'm going to try to get this chat pulled up and we'll see how we can support you guys this morning as we look to make some money on this solar eclipse day, all right? Second.
Yeah, so we can look into the charts here. All right, and we can see from the open, we were originally down 36. Now we're only down 23. Our Bitcoin long has done very, very well and shot up. Now we're up 6K on that. So we'll go ahead and lock in about 5K on here. All right, got 5K locked in on that. All right, NIM, we're up 572 on NIM. It's not really showing our trade, but let's go ahead and lock in 400 on there. Once we put our stop loss on these, we'll see what we have actively for today.
I have a couple.
All right. No, go ahead.
Okay. All right. So currently we have good morning, everyone. Everyone's sending you obviously tons of well wishes. MWMS said, Dion, feel better soon, bro. We need upbeat Dion back ASAP, right? I'm like, yeah, he is. So he's been like this all weekend, y'all, just like, literally, okay? Literally, I'm just like, oh my gosh. But yeah, I do hope that he feels better very, very soon. I've been trying to doctor him up all weekend. I'm playing Dr. Broadway I've been playing Dr. Broadway, I feel like, for the past 8 days. So,
yeah.
Where's my, somebody say my doctor license. Okay. The Modern Vet, good morning, wants Merc, Swing, and Options. All right. So, let's go over here and check out Merc. M-E-R. Boom, here we go. All right, so currently on our 1 minute chart, we are in a buy put, okay? We're currently in a buy put for Merc on the 1 minute chart. As you can see, it looks like it's falling slightly here. Also, it is down about 60 cents or so already. And then the 3 minute chart and the 5 minute chart are all saying buy put, okay? Same thing with that 15 minute. Curious to look at the day. Even the day is also saying buy put. So all the data is saying be on the sell side or the put side with Merc currently. Let me go back and check the 1 minute again. Yep, so that's kind of what the data is saying for Merc. Looks like the put side is where you would be profitable. Wait, now we just got this buy call. It just switched up on us. Hold up. It just switched up on us. That 1 minute, three. Okay, this whole chart just like switch around. We all are buy put. All right, now we're getting buy call, okay? So apparently, I don't know if the chart was wrong, whatever, but now we're getting buy call on the 1 minute, the three, yep. Go back to the three, five, that day is still in the put. So I would say from a short time frame, it looks like this stock is actually starting to rise. Oh, I see what happened. So we just had some news that came in. Berenberg just raised the price target for Merc to $143. Typically, when those price targets get jumped or increased, the stock will tend to move a little bit. So it looks like we're a lot of mixed signals, honestly, on Merc. But I think that news that just came out pushed it up a little bit. So now in our 1, 3, 5, we all are in buy calls. The longer time frame, 15 minutes, 1 hour, 2 hour, day, are all in puts. Okay. All right. So Nita wants a Tesla. Tesla put. All right. So currently Tesla is up $6.11. So not sure if you necessarily want to be on the put side of Tesla today. As you know, they did, as Dion mentioned in the earlier segment, they released that they're, or announced that they're going to be having these Tesla taxis. Tesla Robo taxis that will come out August 8th, which is like very soon, by the way. So I'm also wondering, just random, who's going to, I know everyone's going to be driving them, but who's going to be managing them? Uber?
No, maybe.
Or is Tesla going to have their own network?
Platform, probably. Probably. I mean, they got their own charging stations, their own.
Yeah.
Everything. So it's probably.
I thought about that. I'm like, how do I call the Tesla taxi? Do I go through Uber or Lyft, or do I? Anyway, point. Super random. I've just.
But they probably will be selling them as well, so companies could be able to buy them. So maybe.
Oh, maybe we can buy one. And be in the taxi business.
I'm not trying.
How would they call us for the taxi? I'm so confused. All right, maybe each if you invest in the cars, they give you a software. So currently Tesla is up right now. You probably don't want to be on the put side of this party. Everyone's excited about the Tesla taxi. Clearly I am too. I'm already trying to buy one. I don't even know if they're for sale. It's giving franchise energy. Like everyone can just buy, you can buy a bulk of taxi, pop them on the road.
Definitely would be interesting to see. We have to read the report or the article.
Yeah, we need a little more information on these Tesla taxis. But currently Tesla is trending up very nicely. We've been in this buy call since 9:33. It's literally going up. It's just went up another dollar or so since I've been yapping about how do I actually order a Tesla taxi. But yes, currently on the buy side with one on the 1 minute, 3, 5, 15. Okay. That day is still in the buy put, but it looks like today is the day that will change and it may be starting to trend up. So all the data is saying you do not want to be on the put side right now. with Tesla. Okay, so we'll continue to see how this moves. It's still up about $6-7 or so. So we'll see how Tesla moves today. But
yeah, a lot of selling pressure coming in the NASDAQ. It's down almost 100 points on this initial opening move. The interest rates are charging up, so interesting to see.
Was there any news this morning?
Let's check. We're going to get ready to hop into some of the charts, too, and do some market analysis. No real news thus far. Okay, let's take a look at the charts here. Excuse me. Okay, so we know pre-market we were down 36. Now we're only down 26. And we set this at 5,000. So if we get stopped out, that'll be our first. It looked like we're probably about to get stopped out. That'll be our first active exit of today. I'm sorry, y'all. I'm battling. And we'll kind of go from there. Let's look at the stocks in play. Tesla, the screener did say sell. We'll take a look. The 1 hour says buy. The 2 hour says buy. The 1 day. So definitely no alignment there. Skipping that. Micron Technologies screener algo says buy. We'll look at the 1 day is in a buy signal. The 2 hour, just got a buy at the open, and the 1 hour. So we'll go ahead and enter into a buy side trade on Micron Technologies. That'll be our first active trade of the day. I wanted to talk about something today about trading, investing, holding, stuff like that. I don't know if I'm gonna have the voice or energy, but I will keep it as a note if I don't. All right, the stock screener has a Coinbase at neutral. Algo has it, Hint Plus has it at 1 hour as a buy, the 2 hour as a buy, and the 1 day in the sale. So we're gonna skip Coinbase. And then Robinhood is neutral on the stock screener algo. The 1 day is in a sell. The 2 hour is in a buy. So we're going to skip those. So our first and only active trade so far is Micron Technologies. We just went long on Micron Technologies. Okay, so that's our first and only live trade of the day. Everything else we're looking at right now is our swing positions that we've been holding. Okay, so now let's go ahead and walk through our watch list. We're going to look at the 1 hour chart. And see if we got some trades that we're going to get ready to put in maybe at 9:45 or 10 o'clock top of the hour, okay? Apple did get a sale at the open, okay? So we'll shortlist Apple for short. Okay, come back to that around 9:45 to 10 a.m. AMD, we did get a sale on AMD at the open. Okay, we'll shortlist that. Amazon is in the middle of a buy signal. We're already long Amazon on the swing trade. We'll keep riding that. ARK B, that is a substantial, both the Bitcoin ETFs got a huge move today. We caught it on the Invesco ETF. We'll see here in a shortly, but we're on the sell side, only down $33, haven't hit our 5%. BlackRock, we're long on BlackRock, currently losing. But it was a buy signal on 3:30, yes, on Friday. The Bitcoin ETF for Invesco. Now, I know I know a lot of people are starting to do the countdown to the Bitcoin halving event that's scheduled to happen this month. So that may be, I had to check to see if there was any other Bitcoin news that had both of these pop like this. We have $5,000 locked in on this one, okay? So we'll continue to ride our ride up. And if you want to add to that or enter it, you can, but we already got 5K in there. So I'm just going to let that rock for now. Google is in the middle of a buy signal. We haven't hit our 5% rule. So we'll just let that rock. IBM. And if you're relatively new to the show, I promise you, I got way more energy and way upbeat normally, but I've been battling all weekend. I just want to push through and get to the show, okay? IBM, JP Morgan, which also has their earnings this Friday. A lot of the financial companies got their earnings this. BlackRock also has their earnings this week. Okay, Cruise, and then after Lockheed Martin, I'm gonna take a break.
Yeah.
Cruise, we're already long on that, holding that up. And then Lockheed Martin also, okay? As far as the futures, we are now in the ES. We just got into the ES, and we're short on the ES, but there is a lot of buying pressure coming into the equity, so might lose that trade. Silver, we are also, we're long on silver. So those are our first two active trades on the futures. There's a lot of buying pressure coming into the NASDAQ. So we took $40 of profit off of there. That's our only realized. We're currently up $406 on the ZB and $78 on the ZN. So right now, overall, realized we're down about 500, or unrealized we're down about 500, realized we're up about 40 bucks. So we'll see how it continues to go, as some, it looks like some buying pressure is coming into the equities quite substantially. Okay, Dominique?
Yeah, it definitely looks like a lot of things are starting to turn around. I see some of those red bars getting a little greenish hue on, trying to make that
your green.
Green grin. Yes, I forgot already. All right, let's go ahead and talk about some of the earnings for the week. And I also want to just say welcome to all of our newbies to the show. Yes, Dion is not usually this monotone and low energy, because if he was, we definitely wouldn't be married, right? So, what a nice break, though, you know? Just being so quiet. But also, I was like, talk to me, say something. But no, he needs to rest his throat. So let's talk about some of the earnings that we have coming out this week. As you know, we are in almost, well, we're not. We're getting there. We're kind of getting to like the thick of earnings season, but we ain't there yet. I feel like after all of these financials come out this Friday, it's gonna that's like the kickoff. So next week probably about to be okay. All right, so we have Monday. Tomorrow, before the market opens, we have Tilray, okay? We also have Cognite. Is that Cog? No. Okay.
C-O-G-N-I.
Okay. Cognite, Neogen as well. And then we also have WD-40 tomorrow after the market close. You know, that we like you know, when your door squeaks, I'm like, girl, you need some WD. Yeah, they just good branding with that, because literally anytime anyone hears a door squeak, no matter what the door is, the first thing that comes to mind is WD.
Mm-hmm. It's good when you can have your company become a verb.
A verb, right?
Oh, yeah, you need to Google that when it's really, you go on the internet and search, but because Google is so popular, Google is the verb when you're looking for something, you're searching for something.
Mm-hmm. Very true. Mm-hmm. We also have Delta coming out Wednesday morning before the open. Very excited for that one. I actually just entered into some calls on Delta as we head into the excitement of it opening. I entered into those a couple minutes ago, and it looks like the market was starting to turn around. We also have Applied Blockchain, Sphere Technologies. And then Wednesday after the close, Rent the Runway, which is a company I used to love. I don't have a membership with them right now, but they always have been like super clutch. All right. So Rent the Runway as well, going into Thursday before the open. Constellation Brands, CarMax, Lovesac, some other random companies, okay? And then Friday, which we're going to call Financial Friday, because literally all the big banks are going to be releasing their earnings. I love this Financial Friday. I feel like they always release their numbers like on the same day. I feel like this was the same like last quarter as well. But we have JP Morgan Chase, Wells Fargo, BlackRock, Citi, Progressive, and State Street. So these are some of the major players. This is really going to give us even just a great idea of how the banking industry is doing in general. JP Morgan Chase, hands down my favorite. Y'all know I'm always long JP Morgan Chase. They are one of the leaders in banking, and I am a Chase client, and I just feel like they treat me so well. So, you know, they treat us so well. So we, you know, hey, a little bit biased right there. But those are some of the earnings. So hopefully you guys make note of all these things. Definitely worth taking a look at Tilray. I can't remember what Tilray does, but we could take a look and see. They'll be releasing those earnings tomorrow morning before the open. So, yeah, I guess we can also hop over
A couple of people got some things in the chat.
Yeah. So, these are shout out to the women's Gamecocks, right? That's the
basketball South Carolina. Carolina. Yeah.
Yeah. We watched it yesterday. That was really cool. See all them black women on that day. I was like, oh yeah, girls. It is our time, black ladies. Okay. All right, so outside of that, we have everyone's wishing you well. Vanessa said, morning, feel better, Dion, feel better. Miss T said, feel better. I just bought the class, excited to get started. Welcome, welcome, congratulations. Welcome to the family. Super, super excited to have you here and excited to, for you to kick off this journey. It's about to be beautiful, hopefully profitable. You're gonna learn so much and grow so much as well, okay? We have Michelle was asking, hey, hi guys, can you look at BX, please? Yes, so let's take a look at BX, and she's not talking about the Bronx. All right, so,
BX.
Yeah. I don't know what BX is, actually, I shouldn't say BX. Oh, Blackstone, okay. So, we take a look at Blackstone, which is not Black Rock, which sometimes people confuse because, like, stone and rocks. Like Blackstone and BlackRock.
So Blackstone is the private equity firm. They actually co-founded BlackRock with Larry Fink, and then they didn't really see eye to eye on a couple of things. Larry Fink spent out and took BlackRock public on his own. So BlackRock did come out of Blackstone.
But he had no creativity with that name. He was just definitely trying to be petty. He's like, "Oh, you're gonna be the stone. I'm gonna be the rock. You know, rocks are bigger than stones." I bet you that's literally how he sat in the room and said it.
But now BlackRock.
He also could have said Boulder. Black Boulder. That's what I would have picked.
BlackRock is now the first asset management company to reach $1 trillion valuation.
So that's impressive. I would have definitely picked Boulder. Boulders are bigger than rocks, but I'm also kind of petty. So.
I'll stop.
Okay. Anyway, so Michelle would like us to look at Blackstone. So BX is Blackstone, not to be confused with BlackRock. And thank you, Dion, for sharing us that story of the Blackstone BlackRock. Currently, Blackstone is trading at $128.26. It's currently up 67 cents this morning. All right. We also currently on the 1 minute chart, we're in a buy put. All right. And then on that 3 minute chart, looks like we've been in a buy call all morning. Looks like it's trying to start trending down a little bit here. So on the 1 minute, we're in the buy put. On the 3 and the 5, we're still in that buy call. Same with the 15 hour, 2 hour day. Okay. Looks like the day, like it started, this is actually the beginning of a nice trend up from the day here. So I wouldn't take this buy put too seriously. I based on all the other data, like all the other charts are literally saying buy call. So if I was gonna get into a trade, I would likely probably be on the call side, despite this buy put that's on the 1 minute chart, because all the longer time frames are in the call side. Okay. All right. Vanessa said, hope you enjoyed the baseball game before you started to feel bad. Let me tell you, I think why he feels bad is because of the baseball game. So it was like, how cold was it, Odell?
Brick.
Like, I don't even know the number. What was it?
It was like
zero. It wasn't. Stop it. It was not below zero.
It was about 35, 40, though.
It was cold. And you were trying to sit out there. And after a while, I was like, I got to go. I'm sorry. I can't do this. Like, it was so cold. It was like, you're just like, yo, it's so cold. You know, just.
Imagine if you'd have worn a little leather you was trying to wear.
Yeah. Yeah.
You wouldn't have been there.
I wouldn't have got out the Uber. Yeah. Okay. So like 20 minutes into the game, I'm like, I'm sorry, babe, I cannot do this anymore. So we left and like walked to like a little speakeasy, which was a vibe. We got to go back there.
For sure.
But you know, then later that evening, I could tell your voice was sounding kind of raspy. And the next morning, he woke up, throwed all messed up. I was like, I told you, you should have walked out. You should have walked out earlier. But anyway, so he did enjoy the game, but we were cold. I couldn't tell you what happened. I mean, baseball's so dry anyway, but.
No, that was actually a good game. A lot of good hits.
A lot of balls were flying in the stands.
Yeah, it was a good game. Phillies, Nationals, they got a little rivalry going on. And then, you know, the bros came up and kind of celebrated for my birthday and stuff like that. So it was cool. It was good. It was a good evening. We don't get out too often. And then for the last 2 weeks, the girls been kicking our butts anyway. So
oh my god,
it was good. It was a good time to get out. We don't really go out that often. So.
Yeah, we don't really go out.
Okay, let's hop into the markets as we approach.
Oh, Lisa has a quick statement.
Go ahead.
You know, Miss Lisa always has like the best statement. Good morning, Miss Lisa. She said, good morning, Dion and Dom. How are you doing today? We're pretty good. You know, Dion's not feeling that great, but we here. Dion, hope you feel better soon.
Thank you.
Pray your hands. I gargle with apple cider vinegar for sore throat. It really works. Please look at CarMax Swing. Yes. So we actually have apple cider vinegar at home. So you're going to gargle with that. I've been having gargle all types of stuff. Okay. So we'll add that to the mix as well. Let's take a quick look at CarMax before we hop over. It looks like we did just get this buy signal on the NASDAQ. So it looks like some of these things are kind of starting to turn around. It's only been in this buy for the last few minutes. But we'll see. So let's take a quick look at CarMax. CarMax is releasing their earnings this week, as we mentioned. So in 3 days, so I think Thursday, I believe CarMax, Thursday morning. All right. So currently on the 5 minute chart, we're still in this buy call. Excuse me. On the 1 minute chart, we're in a buy put. And it looks like this bar is attempting to turn around. CarMax is currently trading at $83.02 and is currently up $1.53. All right. So on that 1 minute chart, we're still in the buy put, but this one looks like he's trying to go up. He's trying to go north. All right. We're still in the buy call on the three. And the five was really somewhere. The 15. Do 2 hour for kicks and giggles, and then the day. So basically, all the other time frames, 3, 5, 15, 1 hour, 2 hour, all saying buy call. The longer time frame is saying buy put, but on the day chart, but it looks like this is the beginning of that trend up here. This bar looks like it's about to be green from being up today. So I would probably be more on the upside, because also you're going to see more volume with this stock as people are heading into the potential earnings of it as well. So yeah, that's my thoughts on CarMax.
Okay. So we'll look, there's a lot of buying pressure coming into the market. We started out the market, pre-market down 36, now we're only down 25. So about $11,000 in profits turnaround so far today, being led by the Bitcoin ETF at 5,600, okay? We'll finish out the rest of the watch list. We finished off at Lockheed Martin, and we will see if we got some buy signals for the top of the hour. There are there's a good amount of buying pressure coming in. So we will see if we have any new signals right here at 10. Okay, so Path did get a buy at the open. So we will look to go long Path at the 10 o'clock. We did short Apple and we did short AMD. So our three active trades so far are, or two for today. No, three for today. We went long on Micron Technologies, and then we short Apple and short AMD. So those are three active trades for today so far. I just shortlist Path for the top of the hour. Okay, Palantir, the Qs, Roblox. So now I'm just going to see if we got something at the top of the hour. Riot did get a buy signal. Okay. So at the top of the hour, we'll go long Riot, SPY, Tesla. Tesla did get a buy at the open. Okay, TSM should have, yeah, for sure. Off that news. That's a $6 billion investment. Well, technically that buy came in Friday at 3:30. So imagine if you'd have got in that buy a Friday at 3:30 at 140, sub 144 on TSM. Shout out to the algo. And VTI. Okay, if you want the exact same algos that you see Dominique and I trading here on the screen, you can visit give me a hint.ai or scan that QR code and it'll take you to the site to learn about the algos. It enables you to trade stocks, bonds, options, futures, forex, and crypto. It generates signals for you on TradingView where you can actively trade. If you want to trade options, you can get the signals from the algo in TradingView, and then you have to execute it on whatever platform you want, because TradingView does not allow options trading. And then we also have some fully autonomous bots in the futures platform called NinjaTrader that trade for you automatically, okay? And they are also natively being built into the Total platform, where all of them will be in-house, okay, as that platform progresses. And it's currently in the pilot program, and it has its up days and it has its rough days, but we're continuing to push through for that Total investment, Total Brokers investment platform. So that'll be coming down the pipeline as well. For the show, we primarily trade, don't necessarily do as much teaching, but if you want to learn from us, you can join the Wall Street Academy, which is our course, okay? So now we're going to go ahead and take this buy signal on path, put our 5% rule in there, and buy this. Let's wait for the 1 minute. 1 minute is in the buy signal, okay? We got about 10 seconds left. All right, as long as this doesn't turn sell, then I may buy it. If so, I'll just wait. So the 1 minute did go to a sell, so I'll wait. Riot, the 1 minute is in a sell as well. Tesla, the 1 minute is in the sell. And TSM, the 1 minute is in a buy. So I'll go ahead and buy TSM. And I will wait until the other ones. I will wait until the other ones get in. Okay, I'll wait until the other ones 1 minute flip around. Okay. You could take over for now.
All right. So go ahead and drop anything that you guys want us to analyze in the chat. Also, friendly reminder that we are. Two weeks, 10, 11 days away from our Miami in-person Money Matrix Live workshop. We are super, super, super excited for this upcoming workshop. So basically, for anyone that does not know, the day is going to start out with a live recording of our show, The Money Matrix, in the morning. And then we'll go into lunch, and then we'll do some learning. Then we'll cap the day off with a happy hour. And then for the VIP ticket holders, we will be going on a sunset cruise, which we're very, very, very excited about. So this is going to be a wonderful day. I'm so excited to be able to meet a lot of you. We are in person, all right? Let us know what link does not work. Which link? Is it for the signals, the hint? If so, I think it might be that little dollar sign at the end. It's messing it up. Athena. Yeah. So it's just givemeahint.ai. Givemeahint.ai. Maybe the little dollar sign that she has on there. So just givemeahint.ai. Okay. What I was going to say about the workshop. Yeah, so make sure you grab your ticket. I think the link will be up soon. We are, like I said, very, very excited to see you guys. Also, the QR code is up for anyone that's interested in a hint, in case the link for some reason wasn't working, but it's givemeahint.ai. You can grab the exact same signals and that we have, okay? So the link is also up for our Miami workshop. Like I said, they'll be taking place in Miami. Should we go ahead and queue up our previous one? All right, for those of you who don't know how we do it, we're going to go ahead and show you what the DC workshop was like, so you could get a little snippet of what you go have in store. But trust me, the Miami one's going to be even better, way better.
Hey, I'm Dominique Broadway, award-winning personal finance expert, and today has been absolutely amazing because we had students fly in from all over the country to spend the day with us.
Today is a very special day because we have our live studio audience here.
So during today's sessions, we got to teach and talk about a lot of things in person. And I think for a lot of people, it's good to be able to actually see someone else do it in person. It was really cool. We got to actually hop into people's phones and computers and set up some of the indicators and strategies for them, which was really, really cool. And then we went into an amazing lunch at one of my favorite restaurants.
I want to take my trading to a higher level. and the information that they gave us today, I know that I will accomplish that.
And since they've been doing the show, I've made 5 figures in 1 month. More than my part-time salary when I was working for Wells Fargo. And the fact that this is something that, a skill that I've been able to build from the training that they offer that no one can ever take away from me is mind-blowing.
I encourage you to get the Wall Street Academy program so you can learn and you can do better than me, because I was in the game and I was losing in the game, but now I have the information to win.
So we are very excited to take this show on the road, to be able to take the Money Matrix live to bigger venues and to be able to touch more people throughout the country.
All right, so as you can see, the DC workshop was totally a vibe, and so excited, like we said, to meet you guys in person. The links are there to grab the remaining few tickets that we have for the workshop, and then the link for the VIP yacht is somewhere as well. I'm sure it will be shared. So yeah, very, very excited for that. All right, so we'll hop back into the chat. Cortez Properties, let me know if you were able to get that link to work for you, okay? I think, yeah, she put the updated one. So yes, the yacht QR code is also posted as well. So you can scan that and grab your yacht access to the yacht, to the evening sunset yacht cruise experience.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. So let's go ahead and hop back into the charts. We are getting the NASDAQ has just been literally been going back and forth. Like, it's very narrow range, which is kind of annoying to me, but like, do something already. You know what I mean? But anyway, Vanessa was saying, can one of you give me any insight on why TSM options cost so much, even though the stock's actual price is very expensive? It seems odd. She said, if this is a Discord question, just tell me.
Yeah, no. So the volatility and volume of options are different from the stock. So the stock market is the stock market. The options market is the options market. Two completely different markets. However, the options market, option contracts are based on the derivatives, okay? So the derivative of TSM options are TSM stock. So TSM stock may only be $120, but because TSM options have a lot of volume and volatility in there, then it's not going to reflect, right? So it's going to reflect just the options activity. And so because TSM has a lot of volume and volatility, that creates the pricing. So volume and volatility has a direct impact on the pricing of options. So the more the demand, the higher the price, okay? So
yeah, and also,
and that goes for every stock option.
Yeah, for sure. And also their options aren't that high.
Well, it's relative.
Yeah, for sure. But I mean, like, compared, based on this, like, if you even look at some other options, some other stocks that are around that price, around the 144 price point, you know, but totally agree. There right now, let's say if you get something that's in the money, 32 days out, about $7.93. But yeah, thank you for that explanation, Dion. All right. No, Ranisha, we did not announce the country yet. We did not announce the country yet. No, not yet. We will. Not yet. All right. Also, too, for anyone, is anyone here in St. Louis? Like, St. Louis is like five people there or something. But anyway, anybody here, if you're in St. Louis, tell me in the chat. I will be there Wednesday for the first stop on my book tour for The Wealth Decision. If you guys have not gotten my book, get my book. All right. You can grab it everywhere that books are sold. Amazon, Barnes & Nobles, Audible, Books A Million, everywhere. Grab the book. People love it. All right. But I will be in St. Louis on Wednesday for a really fun kind of book tour event. So no one has responded about being St. Louis. No one here is in St. Louis, okay? All right, Miss Rita, good morning. She said, good morning, Dom and Dion. Hope Dion feels better soon. I'll be watching from Vegas the next few days, so setting alarm for 6 a.m. PST. Please take a look at JPM for options. Thank you in advance. So you just want to rub it in that you're in Vegas,
Miss Rita.
We got it. We got it. Okay, you're in Vegas. We got it. I hope you're there for fun. What am I looking for? Hopefully you are there for fun. You get to like chill and spend some of that money you've been making. Because I know you've been making a lot of money in the market. All right. So she wants to look at JPM. Yes. So JP Morgan got another buy on the NASDAQ. Just does what it does. This is actually the highest it's been though. And it lasts a long time. Uh-oh. Maybe we got a little breakout. All right, so JPM. JPM is JP Morgan Chase. All right, JP Morgan Chase. All right, so currently on the day chart, they are in a buy call. All right, they're currently in a buy call. There was some news that literally just came out about it. It says JP Morgan Chase board planning CEO transition. CEO Daniel Pinto immediately ready if needed. Okay. So, all right. Anyway, so we're talking about, yes. So currently we're in a buy call on the day chart. As we mentioned earlier, JP Morgan Chase will be releasing their earnings Friday morning. So in that day chart, we are in a buy call. On the 2-hour chart, we're in a buy call. 1-hour chart, we're in a buy call. 15, same, 5, we're still in the put, 3, put, but this bar is trying to turn around. And then on that one, we're in a buy call. So all major things are saying buy calls. It looks like there's still some upside potential for JP Morgan Chase. And as I mentioned, they're currently up about 77 cents or so. It's currently in a buy call. So it'll probably trend up, honestly, a lot this week. Who knows? But they've done really, really well with their earnings. I'm trying to remember how they did last time. Oh, their last earnings, they were up $2.11 and then fell about $5.70. They had great numbers, though. The last, for that, they were down 98 cents. So not a big movement. But the day before that, I think they had jumped up a couple bucks. So interested to see how this is going to pan out. For sure. But we do have the whole week to go. Do we have a lot? Do we have any major news this week in general?
Let's check it out.
Okay. And while you do that, Anthony George said, Hey, Dion.
Hey.
When you say that the futures market will be buy side bias, does that mean there will be a lot of buying pressure or selling? Just looking for clarity on the language.
So if the charts are showing buy, I say that we are looking buy side bias based off of that data.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Tomorrow, economic optimism report is tentatively coming out. Excuse me. Wednesday, core CPI and the CPI numbers. At 8:45 on Wednesday, Member Bowman is speaking from the FOMC. Wednesday at 10 a.m., the final wholesale inventories. Wednesday at 10:30, the crude oil inventories. Wednesday at 1:01, the 10-year bond auction. A lot of activity on Wednesday. 2 o'clock FOMC meeting minutes and the federal budget balance announcement.
So basically a lot of
Wednesday and Thursday
and Friday. Consumer sentiment
Friday.
So the second half of the week, a lot of news that could move the markets. Okay. Okay. Thank you for that, answering Anthony's question. Zuri says she's celebrating her sister's 65th, her cousin from Chicago, hey. Michael Freeman.
Hey.
is you know him?
I don't know.
Michael Freeman is here too. He doesn't know any pouncils. Okay. So, pouncils. All right. Okay. Thank you for researching that for us, Miss Rita. All right. Miss Suzanne, hello. Good morning, Miss Suzanne. Could you analyze SYF for option calls, please? Of course. Take a look and see what that is. I don't know off the top. Oh, Synchrony. Awesome. Okay. So Synchrony Financial. All right. Synchrony Financial. So currently trading around $42.34. All right. Now we are looking at the day chart. They're currently up 2.57%. They're up about $1.06. On the day chart, we are in a buy call. Okay. On the week chart, we are in a buy call. 1 minute buy call. 3, 5, 15. So all the charts are saying buy call. So lots of synergy on every single chart. Looks like this has some upside. Our earnings, their earnings actually comes out in about 16 days from now. Is their next earnings report as well. So yes, that is Synchrony. It has a lot of Synchrony. No, it's energy. No. Anyway, all right, anything else that you guys are looking at this morning? I will say, I thought the market was gonna be a little bit more busting this morning. And it's been just in this little tight little range all morning long.
Mm-hmm. No real trends or breakouts. Okay.
Miss Suzanne said, I was wondering if the treat will be in Costa Rica. Maybe, maybe not.
Okay, so PATH has come over into the buy signal. So we'll go ahead and enter into our PATH trade. Put our stop loss at 5%. Okay. Riot. Still in a sale. Tesla. Still in a sale. And TSM. Is now, we enter TSM. Okay, so we're up $80 on TSM. Okay. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right. Anybody else have anything you want to analyze this morning? I wanted to look at Tilray as well. So let's take a quick look at Tilray. I totally forgot about that. So Tilray is announcing their earnings tomorrow morning before the closing bell. Okay. They are currently, what would you call this? They focus on, this is cannabis, that's right. Because they were, other one we just traded. You know what I'm talking about. Other cannabis. But anyway, so Tilray is a cannabis lifestyle consumer packaged goods. They focus on medicinal or medical cannabis, okay? So they're releasing their earnings tomorrow morning before the market open. All right, they're currently trading around $2.57. Okay, $2.57 is where they're at. They're currently down about 3 cents. Now, on our week chart, let's start on the longer time frames. On the week chart, we're still in the buy call. It looks like Tilray has been trending up since since March 18th. Okay, and it looks like it has literally been trending up since then on the week chart. On the day chart, it's also in this buy call as it heads, into its earnings, which come out, as I mentioned, tomorrow morning. All right. And then, they're expanding. They're doing 420 activations across Canada. So it looks like they're expanding to Canada as well. Okay. Yes, I'll do the SPY. So on the day chart, we're in a buy call. On the 2 hour chart, we are in this buy put, which makes sense because it is currently down. Energy 1 hour is also on the buy put. So basically all the shorter time frames are in the buy put. It looks like this is trying to turn around and form into a buy call. So we have to actually wait for this one. But all the shorter time frames are saying buy put. The longer time frames are all saying buy call. They have upside potential. How they're going to do with their earnings, obviously, you never really know how the stock is going to move. with the earnings. Interested to see how they did last time. They fell, looks like they fell pretty sharply ish for them, because the stock is only trading at $2. And at that time it was trading closer to $2 and like $1.86, but it fell about 11% from their last earnings. Okay. And the earnings previous to that as well. So they tend to do, yeah, every earnings they've had looks like they've fallen, except quarter this was, which was July 2023. So yeah, we'll see how they go, but they have been in this uptrend, it looks like, for the last few weeks, but the shorter time frames are all thin by foot. Okay, so SPY for Sovereign, all right, so currently on the day chart we are in this buy put. Does look like this bar is attempting to change, but we had a lot of kind of down days last week. Currently up 0.03% on our one. Sorry, I'm currently day chart. Day chart when a buy put. Okay, we chart. We are in a buy call. 2 hour. We're in that buy call as well. 1 hour. We are in a buy call. 5, we're in a put. 3, we are in a call. And then 1 minute, we are in a call. So no synergy whatsoever, basically. All right, so looks like there's a lot of upside as far as, so like the intermediate time frames are like kind of saying buy put. But some of the shorter time frames, the 1 minute, but also the day and a week, the week are all saying buy call. So it looks like there's some upside potential, especially if we think that the equities may continue to push up today. Right now, I feel like things are just consolidating. It's just in a lull. So it got to break out one way or another, or it could just lull here all day if it wants to, which is possible. So not a lot of synergy, but as you can see on this 1 minute, this buy call is very accurate. It is starting to rise. Boom, another bar just shot up. So yeah, we'll probably be on the call side at least right now. All right. Okay, so safe lows. So can you repeat how we can get the buy sell indicators that you are using for options? How will we get help with learning to use them? Yes. Happy that you asked that question. So to get the same indicators that we have, you can go to giveMeAHint.ai. Okay, giveMeAHint.ai. That is how you can use our software to receive those indicators or buy or sell signals on your charts, okay? GiveMeAHint.ai. As far as using those specific indicators, we have some how-to videos that show you how to set them up and use them. If you want to learn the ins and outs of actually trading and investing, we have a program called the Wall Street Academy for that, okay? So those are those kind of an answer to both of those questions from the learning aspect, learning the fundamentals, Wall Street Academy. If you're buying the hint indicators, we have how-to videos that show you how to like set that up, et cetera, et cetera. Okay. All right. So we are.
You want to talk about the retreat?
Yeah, it's our retreat. This narrow range trade today is literally, it's just so funny. It's like
some buying pressure coming in.
Well, come so on in, man. You act like it's gonna come in, then they be like, psych. I mean, look at this range. This is ridiculous. Like all morning. Are you on my chart? Look at this. Mm-hmm. It's just all morning. All morning. It ain't gone nowhere. Just chilling. Lazy. I get it. It's Monday. We all tired, but like, we trying to make some money here. Okay. All right. Yeah, so let's talk about the retreat. The retreat. Location is still TBD. Okay, I'm seeing the buying pressure. I'm seeing it. I don't want to get too hyped because it psyched me out last time. But anyway, we have not announced the country or city yet for our retreat, but we will be announcing it soon. And just so you know what the retreat vibe is like, which is totally different from the workshop vibe, Odell, drop the tape.
Turn the music up too. What's better than 1 billionaire? Two. What's better than 1 billionaire? Two. What's better than 1 billionaire? Two. Especially if they from the same hue as you. Y'all stop me when I stop telling the truth. What's better than 1 billionaire? Two. What's better than 1 billionaire? Two. What's better than 1 billionaire? Two. Especially if they from the same hue as you. What's better than 1 billionaire? Two. What's better than 1 billionaire? Two. What's better than 1 billionaire? Two. Especially if they from the same hue as you. What's better than 1 billionaire? Two. What's better than 1 billionaire? Two. What's better than 1 billionaire? Two. Especially if they from the same hue as you. Y'all stop me when I stop telling the truth.
All right, and we're back. As you can see, it was literally lit. I always like to say,
literally
really lit with the fireworks. So we're really excited to announce the country very, very soon. Safos is asking, are the retreats for beginners? All of our stuff is for beginners, intermediate, wherever you are. We can help you get to the next level, okay? But we'd like to break it down, keep things simple so that it is easily digestible no matter where you are in your investing and trading journey, okay? Mm-hmm. All right, so do you want to say anything?
No, go ahead.
Okay, so Lockheed Martin, aka LMT, all right, for Miss Teresa here. So Lockheed Martin on a 1 minute chart, we literally just received a buy call, literally right now, Miss Teresa, literally right now, right now. Right now, okay? The buy call just came through right now on the 1 minute chart. We'll see if that sticks. The longer time frames, 3, 5, 15, are still in that buy put because that is where it has been all morning. All right, same thing there. The day chart and the week chart are all in calls, buy calls, okay? But we did just get that first kind of, not first, but I guess second buy signal this morning, okay? Second buy signal this morning. So looks like it may be about to do something. Might be about to do something, Miss Teresa. So this might be the time. Might be the time to enter. Let me see if I can refresh this. Oh, it's like stuck. Let's see. Clock moving. Okay. Boom. Now the buy puts back. So with that being said, no synergy. I would probably hold because all the longer time frames are definitely saying buy call. But this morning it looks like it's been in a little bit of a lull. Okay. So hopefully that's helpful. But I probably wouldn't enter it because it's no synergy. All right. So kicking it with Nadi said, this is my first time joining. I've been interested in learning for a while now. Welcome. Good morning. Welcome to the Money Matrix. I am Dominique Broadway. This is my husband, Dion Pouncil. He's usually really fun and upbeat, but he has a sore throat.
Yeah.
Okay. So if you don't believe me, go check one of the replays from like a couple weeks ago and you'll see he actually really is fun. But his throat is like, it's tied. He's tied. Yeah. Okay. Good morning. Good morning, learning with Lanessa. She said, hello, first time here. Hello, good morning. I love when people do that. It reminds me of church. Like, hey, all of our first timers, please stand up and tell us where you're from. And if anyone recommended that you come here, we welcome you.
Absolutely. Thank you guys for joining. Please click the subscribe button.
Yeah.
Hit the bell, turn on notifications. It'll let you know when we are live. We cover stocks, bonds, options, futures, forex, and crypto here. We do investing. We have our watch list that we give away for free. We picked our 2024 watch list at the top of the year. We give it away for free in our Discord. So you could join our
Okay.
The Discord NASDAQ community and join for free. It's all good. And getting around like-minded individuals and just rock with us, ask questions, be supported, et cetera, et cetera. And, you know, just watch the show daily. We cover headlines, we cover the news, we cover what's going on in the markets. And, you know, it's interesting, it's exciting, but more importantly, it's education. It allows you to be exposed to what's going on in the money markets and in the number one game on the planet, which is the money game.
Yep, for sure. We are finally, as Deon mentioned, getting that buying pressure coming into the NASDAQ because it's been leveling all morning. Finally, it's moving somewhere. So if you're in any QQQs or SPYs, those should probably be profitable. We're also seeing, I saw SMCI was previously down $30, now it's only down 19. NVIDIA was previously down $7-8, now it's only down $1.96. So a lot of these major players are starting to flip the switch the script, whatever you want to call it, and go to that upside, all right? So we can get that deluxe apartment in the sky.
Hey.
All right, I was going to say something else. So welcome to all of you guys. Lanessa is in Houston. Awesome. I used to live there, actually. Yes, also to all of our newbies throughout the show, you are more than welcome to drop any stocks, futures, forex, crypto, gold, silver, oil.
Yeah, anything you want us to analyze using our algos in real time.
Yep, in real time. In real time. Miss Teresa, let me check back on LMT for you because it wasn't really. Miss Teresa is giving put energy over here. You probably gonna make money with the put side. All right, but the NASDAQ is finally going north, like my husband said it would. Finally, there we go. Go on up. Thank you. Give me my money.
Right?
Yes. So that'll be good. Nadi said, "I'm from Michigan. I'm here from my last webinar this Saturday. It was a fun webinar. It was long." Y'all be asking so many questions. Y'all know I love to answer a question. So shout out to all the newbies from the webinar. It's great to see y'all last Saturday. Happy to see you this Monday. You're showing up. You're taking action, right? You're action taker. Action takers win because they take action.
Love to hear it.
I gotta speak for them. Love to hear it. Love to see it.
Yeah. I'm battling y'all. I promise.
I know. I can tell. But at least you look nice.
Oh, thank you, baby. Yeah, this weekend.
What the black folks say? We don't never look like what we going through.
Because
you look really nice.
It's so crazy. I was talking to Dominique earlier. I was like, you know, sometimes you just don't even pay attention to stuff until it's bothering you.
Yeah.
You know, and it's like
this thing that's swollen his throat. I literally almost like.
He's
like, look. I was like, oh. I was like, what the hell? You want to go to the emergency room? He's like, no. I'm like, we need to go to the emergency room. I've never seen that. You know that little thing that be in the back of your throat that hangs or whatever, like it just be chilling, like minding his business your whole life. Well, his is swollen. I'm like, what the hell? So I Googled it, and thank God, this is probably one of the first times I Googled something, and they were just like, you know, it's from a cold irritation, like he'll be fine. I was like, oh Lord, his whole throat about to shut down because it was
nasty.
Anyway, yes, we are here. Khalidra said, I really appreciate y'all pushing through when y'all aren't feeling 100 just to bless us, sending healing energy and healthy vibes to your entire household. God bless y'all. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Because the household has been struggling, a whole house, okay?
Battle.
Safe Low said, yeah, you want to see the TSM? Sure, I'll take you a little TSM again. NVIDIA is about to go profitable for the day, and it's going. All right, TSM, we have that buy call. Yeah, so as you can see, a lot of these things are starting to push up in that 1 minute chart. We're definitely in the buy call 135. So TSM look like it's heading up. All right, also NVIDIA is pushing. We got that buy call in the 5 minute. Also got that buy call in the 1 minute. And this buy call that came through, as you can see, NVIDIA is still down technically like 50 something cents, 80 something cents. But this buy call basically just erased the amount that it was down. It was down about $6-7 today. Okay, the NASDAQ is finally just starting to push up here, which is great. Okay, And as I said, yes, I agree. You never realize how important body parts are until they don't work. No, it's so crazy. I think that's happened. All of us are like, this, I never thought about this. You know, for me, it's been the ears. It's been like, I lost 5% of my hearing when I had Dawson, which was so random. So my ears have literally been clogged. Dawson will be 5 in September, y'all. My ears have been clogged since, for 5 years, basically, which is crazy. So I went to the doctor and I'm like, fix my ears. And they're like, we can't, because basically my brain is trying to make up for the fact that there's a little bit of a loss. So that's like the pressure. So now I'm just used to it, but it is very annoying and it gets worse on planes, but it's something that like I took for granted, just hearing, you know? So yeah, very, very true. Cortez, Stephanie, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Okay, okay. Welcome, welcome. Milwaukee. One of my best friends, Diana, is from Milwaukee.
Yeah, I got sisters and brothers. Well, sister and brother there, too.
Michelle say, y'all know employers usually tell their employees if they're sick that they should stay home. Appreciate your presence here, though. Yeah. See, that's what happens when you work for yourself, right? You know, I don't have nobody to be like, oh, you can stay home. I mean, we could, technically. But we do like showing up for y'all. Y'all know we like showing up for y'all. So, yeah. Oh, that's that. So the NASDAQ is starting to push up a little here. NVIDIA is struggling, trying to go profitable, and it is dry. Okay. Learning what it needs to say, oh my gosh, I'm dealing with the same. My left ear, and this weekend, my whole mouth became sick. Not giving details, but oh my God. Yeah, our bodies are very intricate. Like, they are something else. Like, even our daughter, Dawson, broke out in hives. We don't even know what it's from. It's just like, Lord Jesus. Hives that don't even itch. I ain't never even heard of hives that don't itch. I'm just like, what's all this new stuff? And then Demi with the, oh my gosh. It's crazy. Mm-hmm. I don't need a hearing aid yet. So my daughter, Miss Pauline, said hearing aid might help. Hear very clearly. So the doctor told me that the reason why I'm not struggling with the hearing is because based on the test, I had higher than average hearing anyway. And so that's why I'm not, the loss of hearing is just constant pressure. So I just feel like my brain needs to know, like, we good. It's just trying to make up for it. That's all. All right. Miss Wilson said, thank you guys pushing through, keeping y'all in my prayers. Thank you. Thank you. All right, so the NASDAQ is slowly, slowly, slowly pushing up. NVIDIA trying to go profitable, bless it. So it's struggling. It's only down about 10 cents. It's trying to go above it, but they not letting that happen. Tesla's up still, $7.52. So that has been riding up today. LMT is still down. Apple is... I don't even really talk about Apple no more, y'all, because no point. It's just down every day. You know, and... I don't like that down energy. Amazon is also, oh, Amazon hit a new 52-week high today. So I know we're definitely long Amazon for sure. So that's cool. Amazon's been doing pretty well. Also, Tesla is the stock that keeps on giving. I'll tell you that. They have a nice dips up and nice. I like a stock that has stocks that have a nice dip up and a nice little dip down. That's how you make money. Shoot, that volatility, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So. Yeah. All right, what else we got to talk about?
I can barely talk, so I got a whole bunch I want to say, but...
Okay. Tommy said, Dion or Dominique, Google long or short? Let's do it. Let's see what Google... They want G-O-G-L. So, Kwame on the one-minute chart. So, Google's actually up $2.49 today. What is this bill? Maryland legislator passes bill on online data privacy. Okay, so Alphabet's price target was just raised to $185. Okay, they're actually up $2.46 today, up $1.61. On that 1 minute chart, we're in a buy call, 3:15. 2 hour day. Day. Week. Every single time frame is saying buy call for Google. Yep.
Okay, so we'll walk through. We could look at the screen and see there's a lot of buying pressure that came in from the NASDAQ. From that third standard deviation, is charged up all the way to the second standard deviation above the VWAP. So maybe getting some resistance here pretty soon. Okay. Collectively, we can see we're still in some active trades, down 800 on silver, up 360 on 380 on crude oil, up 625 on the bonds and on the 30 years and $78 on the 10 years. Excuse me. Remember pre-market, we were down 36, then we went down to 23, now we're down 29. So still up about $7,000 today so far. Our active trades for today, we went long TSM, currently profitable on that. We were waiting on Tesla to turn around and finally turned around. So we're going to go ahead and get in Tesla. All right. Put our 5% stop loss on there. Okay, so if you're relatively new, everything on this watch list, we give it away for free in the Discord. This is our 2024 picks where we're investing. So this means that every one of these we're buying and holding for 1 year or longer, okay? But we also will day trade and swing trade. We will also day trade and swing trade the same watch list. So if we're in a long position, we're okay with holding that long position from a day trade into a swing trade because we're long on these positions anyway. Okay, so we're open to holding it as long as it doesn't hit our 5% rule. So we essentially use our algorithms to get in or out, and then we have our 5% rule on there for our risk management. Okay, so we just got into Tesla. All right, we did Riot. We're waiting for the buy side of Riot. I don't believe we got in there. We got a buy signal in the 1 hour, but we're waiting for the 1 minute. Okay, yeah. We put an order in. We didn't get filled yet on Riot. Okay. And then Path. Path. We went long on Path. Did we get filled? A lot of selling pressure coming into the market right now. Yeah, we went long on Path. Okay. And getting hit on that. Okay. I think we added to that position though, actually. We added to that position. So that's fine. And then we sold Apple. So down $11 on the Apple short. And then we sold AMD. Okay. AMD did get a buy on the 1 hour at the top of the hour at 10. So we took that sale at the opening bell. So all in all, in our active day trades, our 5% rules are set up. If you want to learn more about the 5% rule of your risk management, just go ahead and join the Wall Street Academy, and we teach you all that step by step, how to protect your money so you can survive in the long game. All right, because it's investing first, build you a generational wealth portfolio, and then actively day and swing trade to make daily and weekly income to replace your job. Okay, so that's some free game right there. I will go on that little tangent for a second because I know we got a bunch of newbies that came in. Learn. First, I need a second.
Some water.
I need some water. Okay.
Okay.
Cool.
Okay.
Let me get this out. learn first, then practice, then start with a small account, then invest for the long term, building generational wealth, build your investment portfolio, then you trade, and you want to trade small to grow your account, and then once you get that confidence and successful, consistent, profitable trading, then you use that to replace your income, replace your job, and then you can live off your money and let your money work for you. Okay, and then you take your trading money, your trading profits, and you take that and you invest that into your long-term portfolio so you can get it up to a level where you can live off your money. Here's some free game for you, and this is probably the last thing I might say for the whole show. You can build a dividend portfolio. You can find out how much you want to live off of. Let's just say you want to live off $100,000 a year, $200,000 a year, and you don't want to work, okay? You put together a dividend portfolio by yourself, learn it through our course, Wall Street Academy, or work with a professional money manager like myself to build you a dividend portfolio. and you build this portfolio up to see how much money do you need in the portfolio that you can literally live off the dividend payments so you never have to work again. If you don't understand the gem that I just gave you, watch this video over 100 times till it click. You can literally live off of your money working for you without going to work, without even trading. You can do it from investing, okay? You gotta have a dividend portfolio. You have to find out how much money you need to put in that dividend portfolio to give you the amount of annual income that you want, because some dividends pay out weekly, some dividends pay out monthly, some dividends pay out quarterly, some dividends pay out semi-annually, and some dividends pay out annually. So you can find that amount by yourself through our course or with the money manager like myself. Get that amount, put it into the markets, into that dividend portfolio, and literally live off your dividend payments. And you never have to work again if you do it correctly, okay? And anybody can do that, okay? Free game right there, okay? So if you're new to the program, you just got a gem of a lifetime, okay? And I probably won't say anything to maybe keep it in the book. If you might have to keep it in the book, but I'm probably not talking for the rest of the show, okay? So love y'all.
All right, cool. Drink some water.
Yeah, I'm out of water. Let me get some of yours.
Okay.
Right.
Okay, so one question. Where do you see the selling pressure and the buying pressure coming into the market?
I'm looking at the charts, number one, and then our algos literally say sell or they say buy. So we put all of this time, energy, effort,
well, I think,
resources.
Like, when you can see the part, yeah. No.
We have time, we have quantitative developers that work with and for us to help build these algorithms. And I also trade a lot off of volume. So when I'm looking at the volume charts, I'm looking at the volume charts with our algorithms on there. So for an example here, I can turn this, actually I'll just duplicate this real quick. Okay. Like I got multiple screens right here. So what y'all only see us and maybe one screen that Odell, our producer, shows you. Oh, that's the tickers, but you don't see it because it's cut off a little bit.
Okay, I was like, what are those circles?
Okay, and of course I was trying to show you now my screen tweaking. I'm not sure what happens. TradingView doesn't have volume charts natively, but NinjaTrader does. So on another screen that you can't see, I have volume charts, and volume allows me to see the market because volume and tick charts calculate every single trade. Time charts only calculate time. So you can see it's loading and it's loading up the algorithm here. So it's going to load up the algorithm and then it's going to show me based off of my algorithm a buy or sell. And I know if it's a buy or sell coming in, right? So I can put on our algorithm, Hint Plus, okay? And let's just say I want to look at a certain thing with my algorithm. With the Hint Plus series, I can see once the algorithm gets done loading, each one of these candlesticks is worth, is calculating 1,000 trades. And so I can see that for the last basically 60 to 100,000 trades, the buying coming in. So I can see buying pressure, okay? So this is buying pressure. My algorithm calculates it and it's telling me that the buying pressure is coming in. So this is how I know buying pressure is coming in, but you can't see this because we only show one chart because it's a whole bunch of stuff to put this whole show in production. But I can see the buying pressure coming in from the algos. And we teach you how to do this step by step. When you buy the algorithms, it comes with how-to videos and we show you how to do this and how to use it. And so I usually will split the screen and I might have the same instrument, but I might be looking at the NASDAQ on a time chart and I might be looking at the NASDAQ on a volume chart because volume moves the market and volume tells me what the actual trading is doing. And this is the buying pressure start coming in at 10 a.m. here on a time chart, but this tells me exactly when it starts coming in because it's calculating every single trade, okay? So y'all getting some free game because I'm under the weather. But we teach all of this in Wall Street Academy, and when you purchase the algo, it comes with these how-to videos that give you extra edge and insight, okay? So hopefully that helps. Okay, for real. You do, keeping it a buck. I'm not talking for the rest
of the show. So, Kignamanati, do y'all teach building our portfolio within the community? Yes, 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 yes. We do. Okay. Nessa said, thank you. We appreciate your efforts.
My pleasure.
All right. Okay, so it's 10:49. We just got another buy signal on NASDAQ. NVIDIA is still struggling to go profitable. Tesla's still holding around that, being up $7. It has been a dry day. Profitable day, but dry day. Okay, that's what it's been. Willem say he's rooting for you. Root for you, man.
Thanks, bro.
I don't know what to talk about, y'all. What y'all doing? Should we talk about lunch? Is it time for that? Lunch? Mm-hmm. I'm gonna ask one more time. Is anyone else living in St. Louis?
Did you do the retreat?
Yeah.
Video?
Yeah.
Okay.
Asking if anyone else lives in St. Louis. But yeah, I want to remind you guys too, for all of our newbies, we are, we did this, right? Mm. Wait, real quick. Wednesday, I'll be in St. Louis for my book signing. If you're in St., literally no one has responded saying they're in St. Louis. We have a lot of people registered that live in St. Louis, but no one here is saying they're in St. Louis, which is fine. But either way, go ahead, buy the book, Target, Barnes & Noble's, Audible, if you want me to read it to you at night. Books a Million, all there, okay? So that's that. Also, friendly reminder, tickets for the Miami workshop. We'll probably have to shut those down soon, okay? So tickets for the Miami workshop, grab those. If you want the same, if you open up your trade, if you open up your charts and your charts are bald, I call them bald, that's what they look like when you open up the chart. You'd be like, what the hell am I supposed to do with this information? These bars that are telling me what happened in the past, you know?
Thoughts of ball.
Past results are no indication of, no, was it? Past performance is no indication of future results. If you want these buy and lovely sell signals that we have in our charts to tell you when to get in and when to get out, high probability trades, so you're not out here just shooting blindly, okay? Go ahead to giveMeAHint.ai. You can subscribe to a indicator of your choice, have it added to your chart, and you'll be over here making a little bit more confident trades than what you might be making right now, okay? Last but not least, the yacht, the VIP yacht, all right? At the end of the, what's it called? At the end of the
workshop,
we will be having a evening cruise. Sunset evening cruise throughout Miami. That's gonna be so vibey. Mm-hmm. Okay, so make sure you grab your ticket for that as well. Okay, Miss Vanessa was saying, oh wait, Cortez, the Dominique, get that man some ginger root tea with honey and lemon. He looks like he's suffering. He is. It's hard to talk for 2 hours. Okay, yeah, we'll give him some tea. We got a couple meetings after this. You go home right now. He's like, I'm done now. I feel you. Okay. Vanessa said, do we have any date ideas for the retreat? Yes, currently right now it's June. End of June. Right. Hopefully we have some updates on that soon, y'all. Okay?
Thank y'all.
Yes, we appreciate all the nice things y'all are saying. Dion Phil of the Phil of the Best ACP. Thank you for all that you do. Much love. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All right. So I did not have a keep it a buck prepared because I thought, okay. But it's not even time. But
it's time because we're going to end this show.
All right. So, okay. Dion, go ahead and keep it a buck.
Okay. All right. So, for our keeping it a buck segment for today, there is no testimony without a test. Okay. Often we want to have great testimonies and share our stories and and things that we've accomplished, right? But we don't realize that we've accomplished it because we went through something, okay? And so there is no testimony without the test. You have to embrace the test, embrace the uncomfort, embrace the struggle, because it's also going to help you appreciate it more, okay? How does that relate to trading? Nobody who has got into trading and investing was as great as they ever were or became on the first day, the first week, the first month, first year. It takes time. So embrace your testing period, right? Learn, practice, go through step by step. It's not a get rich quick scheme. And then you're also going to appreciate it even more. Okay. So that is our keeping the buck segment for today. Embrace the tests. Understand that everything is working for you to become the person you're destined to be. And then you'll be able to share that great testimony. All right.
Amen. Amen. Jeffrey said it's only a test. He also said that was his sermon, our sermon yesterday. Teresa said, thanks, feel better, Dion. Blessings, DBDP, MM fam. Yes, thank you guys so much for tuning in to another. Ready to wrap? All right. Thank you guys so much for tuning in to another episode of The Money Matrix. We really appreciate you guys pushing through with us over the last couple weeks because we have been Lord, under attack, okay? Because that means something big is coming because, man, even the baby's been catching the suffering. So, yes, thank you all so much. Hopefully you have an amazing and profitable trading day. Don't forget we have some really cool earnings coming out this week. Tilray is one of the major ones releasing their earnings tomorrow morning before the opening bell. Have an absolutely amazing day, and we will see you guys tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time for another episode of The Money Matrix.
Thanks, y'all. Peace.